गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नॉट टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद फ्यू मोर टॉपिक्स ऑफ द चैप्टर एयर. ओके, सो इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द एयर, अबाउट इट्स प्रेजेंस इन सॉइल. ओके, मेनी अदर थिंग्स आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू. सो व्हाट आई हैव टोल्ड, लेट अस रिवाइज अगेन दैट आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट एयर इज actually a non-visible thing. Okay, air we cannot see with our naked eyes. That is why the glass which is empty kept in your house, the empty classroom, the empty rooms is actually not empty. Why? Because air is filled at every corner of that room, of that classroom, of that glass. Okay, so that means anything is not empty. On that air is filled. Okay, then we have studied that air is lighter as compared to water. That is why air is removed by the upward displacement of air. Air is removed by upward displacement and water is heavier, so it will settle in glass. We have taken the example of glass. So what happens in glass? Air is filled. If it is empty, when we will hold water on it, then water will settle down. Why? Because it is heavier. And air, which is resides over there at that time, will come out by the upward displacement. Okay? Then we have studied about that, about soil. Then we have studied about soil, that soil is actually a porous content. Why? Because there are many pores present in the soil. And on that pores, oxygen is actually filled. Why? Because on that pores, air is resides over there. Okay, in soil. If there is air, then there is oxygen. Then what happens? Those insects, earthworm, snakes, flies, anything else, any other insect, there are many insects which who resides inside the soil. So they take oxygen from that soil pores. Okay, why? Because on that pores, air is filled and oxygen is present on that. So they reside inside the soil because of the presence of oxygen. Okay, that means air is resides in the soil. Okay, then what we have done? We have done an experiment that in a glass of water, when we poured a few, two, three, or just one, one or two gram of soil on it, what happens? We will see that there are few minute air bubbles rises up. Okay, air bubbles rises up. So this experiment proves that air contains oxygen on it. That is why the air bubbles rises in upward direction. Now today we will study about, does water contains air? So answer is yes, water also contains air. That is why air has oxygen on it, and because of that only many animals and plants resides in the water. For example, fish, we all know crocodile, snakes, and many other rhinoceros and all, many other animals, insects, all resides in the water. There are many plants, phytoplanktons and cytoplankton. There are many plants also who live inside the water. Okay, so what happens? They take oxygen from the water. Okay, we know fish take oxygen from the water. So from there they take oxygen. This proves that water also contains oxygen. That means water has air on it, and on the presence of air, what happens? It gives oxygen to the water living animals and plants. Okay, now see here, we will do one experiment also. See here, this is a report stand. Okay, on that report stand, we have taken a container. Okay, we have taken a container. On that container, water is filled. Okay, on that container, water is filled. Now what we will do? We will take a Bunsen burner. Okay, we will take a bunsen burner and we will light it with the flame. We will light it with the flame. Okay, this is bunsen burner. Bunsen burner, it is used to light the container. Okay, and here it is water. Here it is water. What happens? As soon as it will give flame, as soon as it will give flame to the container, as soon as it will give flame to the container, what happens? The water kept in the container will start taking heat from the burner and start, and temperature, what happens? The temperature of the water will start rising up, and the condition will come at certain time that what happens, that water will gain much amount of heat and it will start boiling. Okay, so when it start boiling, what happens? A few bubbles we will start seeing. Okay, these are air bubbles. A few bubbles we will start seeing, which is going from lower concentration to higher concentration. Okay, few bubbles we will see which will move from lower concentration to higher concentration. So these are known as air bubbles. Okay, so what happens when temperature will be high? Then air content will start evaporating off. That means it will start taking off from the water. Okay, the higher the temperature, the lower is the solubility of air. Okay, this experiment proves that in water air is present. This experiment proves that in water what happens? Air is present. That is why they are seen in the form of bubbles. Okay. Now one more thing, when temperature is high, that means higher the temperature, less will be the solubility of air. Higher the temperature, less will be the solubility of air. The more temperature raised in the water, as soon as it will gain more temperature, what happens? The solubility of air will become less. Okay, why? Because when it will gain more temperature, that means what? It has taken heat, and due to the heat, what happens? The air which is present in the water will evaporate off in the form of air bubbles. So the content of air mixture is become less in water. So this is the conclusion of the experiment, that higher the temperature, less will be the solubility in air. And this experiment proves that water contains air, and we all know that many of the animals, plants, insects and live inside the water only because of the presence of oxygen. And if there is oxygen, then there is air also. Okay, now next we have to study about what is air made up of? It is given on the page number 65. What is air made up of? What is air made of? Okay. So it is made up of matter. Air is made up of matter. Answer is, air is made up of matter. Air is made up of matter. Answer is, air is made up of matter. See, here it is written in the book that air is made up of matter. It occupies space and has mass. Okay, it occupies space and has mass. When you blow air into a balloon, you can easily understand that air occupies space. The more you blow, the larger is the space it occupies. Okay. So yes, you all have known balloon in your birthday and all, in your sister and brother's birthday. Okay. So you know that when you blow air inside the balloon, it will take space in the balloon. it will take space. The more you blow, the more space is needed in the balloon. So air needs space, and air also what happens? Air needs space, and it occupies space, and it has mass also. So air occupies space. कवर करता है, जैसे हमने बताया बैलून में हवा भरने से बैलून क्या है बढ़ता है, तो स्पेस बढ़ रहा है एयर की वजह से, तो एयर क्या है स्पेस को कवर करता ही है, साथ में वो क्या है भारी भी हो जाता है ना। सो वी विल टेक आर रूलर, सपोज वी हैव टेकन आर रूलर, दिस इज अ रूलर, ओके दिस इज अ रूलर, ओके दिस इज अ मार्किंग इन द रूलर, we have taken a ruler, this is known as ruler or scale, ruler or scale, okay. Now what we do, we will place here a balloon, we will place here a balloon, this is an inflated balloon, okay, inflated balloon. This is also inflated. Okay, so what we have done, we have taken a ruler and we will place two inflated balloon at two of its end. That means at one end we have placed one balloon, at another end we have placed another balloon. Okay, so at that time we will see that the ruler is in a horizontal position. At this time, when both the balloon is inflated, then at this time ruler is in a horizontal position. But as soon as we will see that. Okay, here what happens? Balloon is filled with air, and here we have not. This is inflated again. Inflated balloon. Okay. So at this condition, see here I will make at another side. See. This is the condition. On both the side you will have inflated balloon placed in the ruler. So ruler is in horizontal position. Okay. Horizontal position. Horizontal. Okay, now here what happens? See, the ruler will become like this. Okay, here what happens? Big balloon is placed here, and here again inflated. This is inflated balloon. Inflated balloon, and this is air filled. Okay, so what we are seeing that when inflated balloon is placed at both of the end, at that end the position of the ruler is horizontal. इस time पे क्या है? Scale एकदम सीधी थी, है ना? ये क्या है? ना तिरछी थी, ना एकदम सीधी थी, ना एकदम इसकी horizontal condition थी, एकदम सीधी थी, यूं थी एकदम. और क्या हुआ? फिर हमने इस तरफ के balloon में at this side we have filled air. Okay, we have blown air. And we have filled air at this side, but at this side the balloon is remain inflated. At this side we have not touched; it remains inflated. So at that time, what we are observing that scale is turned. Okay, scale is turned. Okay, in a slant position. This is a slant position. Okay, slant. Slant meaning tirchi. Slant position of scale. This is slant position of scale. Slant means तिरछी हो जाना, ठीक है? यहाँ पे हमने क्या देखा, जहाँ पे हमने इस वाले balloon में air भर दिया और इसमें नहीं कुछ air भरा, तो हम देख रहे हैं कि ये क्या है, इसमें air होने के ये इसको लटका दिया नीचे स्केल को, ठीक है। इसका मतलब एयर क्या है, एयर हैज एयर ऑक्यूपाइज स्टेट एंड इट हैज मास। ये एक्सपेरिमेंट प्रूव करता है कि एयर ऑक्यूपाइज स्पेस एंड इट हैज मास आल्सो। ओके, इसमें क्या है, एयर बढ़ गया, एयर बढ़ने की वजह से स्केल क्या लटक गया और यहां कुछ नहीं किया, ये वैसे ही है। दैट इज व्हाई इट प्रूव दैट एयर ऑक्यूपाइज स्पेस एंड इट हैज मास। ओके, सो दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट प्रूव दैट। ओके, नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट एयर इज एक्चुअली, नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट एयर इज एक्चुअली अ मिक्सचर, मिक्सचर ऑफ सर्टेन सर्टेन गैसेस। इन एयर देयर आर मेनी गैसेस प्रेजेंट इन द एयर। ओके, वी नो दैट देयर आर ऑक्सीजन, देन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, नाइट्रोजन, वाटर वेपर, ओके, एंड देयर आर मेनी अदर गैसेस प्रेजेंट इन द एयर। ओके, सो एयर इज एक्चुअली अ मिक्सचर ऑफ मेनी अदर गैसेस। ओके, सो सी हियर द कंपोजिशन ऑफ एयर। ओके, द कंपोजिशन ऑफ एयर, दैट मींस कंपोजिशन मींस व्हाट, दैट इन एयर दोज गैसेस व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट लाइक नाइट्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, ओके, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, वाटर वेपर, सो दे आर प्रेजेंट एट व्हाट अमाउंट इन द एयर। ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड कंपोजिशन ऑफ एयर। ओके, सी हियर कंपोजिशन, पोजिशन ऑफ एयर, because we all know that air is actually a mixture, so air contains nitrogen. Okay, air contains nitrogen, then it contains oxygen also. Okay, oxygen, then it contains carbon dioxide, water vapor and other gases. Okay, it contains carbon dioxide, carbon dioxide, water vapor, water vapor and other gases. Okay, so nitrogen is from the oxygen, so they are in, this is 78%, then we have oxygen almost 21%, okay, this is 21% and carbon dioxide and other gases is 0.9%. Okay, so these are it has 71%, 21% and 0.9%. So the maximum content of gas is nitrogen present in here. The maximum content is nitrogen, that is 78.1%. Then you will have oxygen, which is 21%. And carbon dioxide with water vapor and other gases makes up 0.9%. So all together this is the composition which makes air, this is the composition which makes air, which is known as blanket of atmosphere. Okay, which is known as blanket of our surrounding. Okay, so till composition I have explained here, you all have to study it very clearly. Okay, rest of the things we will study in our next video. Thank you.